Dear students, welcome to EPG Patshala. I am Professor P. Bhaskar Reddy, Department of Ancient Indian History, Culture and Archaeology, Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati, the principal investigator of the subject Indian Culture and course coordinator for the paper Museology. In this module, you are going to learn about the Sala Jung Museum, Hyderabad. By the end of this module, you will be able to learn the history of the Sala Jung Museum, its collections and galleries, library and manuscripts, museum exhibitions, important objects of the gallery, unique objects of the museum exhibition, and with a summary. Let us start with the history of Sala Jung Museum. Sala Jung Museum is situated on the right bank of the Musi River at Hyderabad. It is the repository of the artistic achievements of diverse European, Asian and Far Eastern countries of the world. The major portion of this collection was acquired by Nawab Mir Yusuf Ali Khan, popularly known as Sala Jung III. In the year 1914, Sala Jung III, after having relinquished the post of Prime Minister, devoted rest of his entire life in collecting and enriching the treasures of art and literature. The precious and rare art objects collected by him for a period of over 40 years find a place in the portals of the Sala Jung Museum as rare to very rare pieces of art. The zeal for acquiring art objects continued a family tradition for three generations of Sala Jungs. Have a look at the Sala Jung Museum, Hyderabad, and its beautiful building. Regarding the Sala Jung family, they were the noble family of erstwhile Hyderabad state from 1720 to 1948. Five members of the family of Sala Jung has served as prime ministers to the Nizams of Hyderabad. Have a look at Sala Jung I, Sala Jung II, and Sala Jung III. Now we can concentrate on the history of the Sala Jung Museum. Now we can start with a brief discussion on the history of museum. Originally, the Sala Jung Museum was housed in the Diwan Diyodi on Pattargatti area of Hyderabad. The museum declared open to the public by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in December 1951. The museum has been named after Sala Jung III. The administration of the museum continued to be vested in the Sala Jung Estate Committee till the year 1958. Thereafter, the heirs of Sala Jung graciously agreed to donate the entire collection to the Government of India through a compromise deed. The museum, along with the library, was declared as an institution of national importance and was transferred to the Government of India through the Parliament Act in the year 1961. In the year 1968, the museum was shifted to the present building. The museum have rich collections and housed in 38 galleries. The museum has magnificent global collection of art and antiquities. The collection of the museum can be divided into Indian art, Middle Eastern art, Far Eastern art, European art, and children's section. The two-storied museum building has 38 galleries. The ground floor has 20 galleries, which run clockwise from the founder's privacy. The first floor has 18 galleries running anti-clockwise, closing with a Japanese gallery. One gallery is devoted to illustrious Sala Jung family, which was mainly responsible for acquiring the collections. Have a look at the the plan of the Salarjung Museum and the galleries housed in different floors. In the entrance of the museum, the first gallery devoted to founders, known as the Founders Gallery. In this gallery, the portraits and the other personal belongings of the family are displayed. The important portraits are Mir Alam, Munir Ul Mulk II, Muhammad Ali Khan, Salarjung I, Salarjung II, and a good number of oil paintings of Salarjung III, displaying various facets of his personality, also adorned in this gallery. Now we can discuss about the different galleries and unique objects displayed in it. The Indian art objects comprising of stone sculptures, bronze images, painted textiles known as kalankari and general textiles, wood carvings, miniature paintings and modern paintings, ivory carvings, jade carvings, metalware, manuscripts and arms and armor are important. The textile gallery is an important gallery. The rich tradition of Indian textiles through varied specimens of fabrics used as well as costumes, furnishings belongs to the last 3 centuries are displayed. Have a look at the textile gallery and the objects displayed in it. The kalankari varieties of Machilipatnam, Palakollu and Kalahasti are also on display. It should be noted that Kalahasti kalankari were famous for producing temple hangings depicting scenes from the Ramayana and Mahabharata. Now, you may have a look at textile gallery. The miniature painting was practiced on cloth, wooden boards, palm leaves, etc. before the introduction of paper in India in 14th century. Several schools of Indian paintings are on display. The paintings of Raja Ravi Verma, Abhinendranath Tagore, Nandal Bose, Chugtai, B.B. Mukherjee, V.S. Masoji, Mughal and Bengali School of Art have also been exhibited in this gallery. The other galleries and objects of the Indian art are Bidri Ware Gallery, Utility Ware Gallery, Ivory Gallery, South Indian Wood Carving Gallery and Wood Carvings, Toys and Dolls Gallery, Flora and Fauna Gallery, Arms and Armors Gallery, Kashmiri Gallery, and the beautiful objects displayed in these galleries are ivory carvings, jade carvings, bidri ware, gems, stone sculptures, bronze sculpture. These are the important collections of the Indian art housed in the respective galleries. Besides Indian art and art objects, several Far Eastern art collections also included in the Salarjung Museum. This museum is one of the few Indian museums which can boast of the fairly extensive collection of Far Eastern art consisting of Sino-Japanese art objects. The collection includes porcelain, bronze ring, wood and inlay work. The Far Eastern art objects is displayed in 4 galleries: Chinese Gallery, Eastern Porcelain Gallery, Japanese Gallery, Eastern Statuary Gallery. Regarding the Chinese collections in the Eastern Gallery, the Chinese art of porcelain representing the most comprehensive range of export wares dating from 12th to 19th centuries Christian era is the remarkable collection. See the Chinese collection. Have a look at the Japanese art gallery. The Japanese art in the museum collection are blue and white porcelain of Harita datable to 17th century Christian era. The Far Eastern gallery is an important collection of objects from various countries. This gallery also presents an interesting picture of the sculptural art of countries like Nepal, Tibet, Thailand and Burma in Southeast Asia, apart from the works of China, Japan in the Far East. The majority of these objects are Buddhist sculptures that show everlasting impact of Buddhism, which has spread from Indian subcontinent to China and Japan. Have a look at Far Eastern Wood Furniture and Carvings Gallery. It is a beautiful collection of forest. Now we will come to Middle Eastern art. The Middle Eastern art is represented through its art objects from Persia, Syria and Egypt, covering the diverse media like carpets, manuscripts, ceramics, glass, metalware, furniture, lacquerware. These objects give a fair idea about the achievements of the craftsmen of these regions in a fitting manner. The Arabic and Persian manuscripts form the most valuable collection in the Middle Eastern art. Egyptian art objects on display are only copies made after the originals from the important tombs of the early Egyptian kings. The Syrian art objects comprise of a good number of furniture items with magnificent work on inlay done in mother of pearl. See the chair of the Egyptian and Syrian art. Have a look at the Egypt and Syrian gallery. The Persian carpets occupy an important place in the Middle Eastern art collections. Few specimens with intricate weaving and decked with different ornamental patterns from Persia are represented in this gallery. Coming to European art, the museum stands unique for its European collections, comprising of art objects ranging from excellent examples of bronze and marble sculptures, glass objects, porcelain, majestic furniture, ivories, enamelware, clocks, oil and watercolor paintings. Have a look at the European Glass Gallery, European Bronzes Gallery, which have a beautiful collections, European Clock Gallery, European Marble Gallery, European Porcelain Gallery, French Gallery. All these exhibits rare pieces of art collection. Among that, Wild Rebecca Gallery is the most beautiful one. One of the most important and interesting object collected by Salar Jung the First was Wild Rebecca, an enchanting marble statue which was acquired by him from Rome in 1876 during his visit to Italy. It is a beautiful art object in the collection of Salar Jung Museum. The double statue Mephistopheles and Margareta, France of 19th century, is another attraction, which Mephistopheles on one side and Margareta on other side. Have a look at the different art objects of these collections. Clocks, European paintings, night watchman in bronze, marble statue, glass objects, porcelain. Coming to the children's section, the objects displayed in the children's section are clay models of Indian village, bronze figures, porcelain ware, music boxes, marble statues and toys from different parts of the world. Have a look at the children's gallery and its beautiful collections of the museum. Besides the art objects of the world, the museum is also important, which it houses manuscripts and a good library with the collection of several books. Have a look at the library and the manuscripts displayed in the gallery. The museum have the rich collection of about 8,000 manuscripts, 14,000 printed books in Arabic, Persian, Turkish and Urdu languages. nearly 29,000 research journals, albums of rare photographs and valuable engravings are also included in its collection. The oldest book in museum collection is The General Histories of the Turks, published in 1631. A Bible in Hebrew in two volumes, published in 1667. The museum also providing so many facilities for the research scholars to refer these rare and important books. Besides the regular display of the museum objects, the Salar Jung Museum also conducted several temporarily occasional exhibitions since its inception. Have a look at the different exhibitions organized by Salar Jung Museum: Bidri Exhibition, Armor Exhibition, Calligraphy Exhibition, Glimpses of Childhood, Glimpses of Kutli Splendor, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Krishna Leela, Kutub Shahis of Golconda, Indochina Porcelain Collection, The Old Salar Jung Museum, Shatavahana Coins, Tanjore Exhibition. Now, after this thorough discussion, now we can sum up this topic with summary and importance of the Salar Jung Museum. The Salar Jung Museum is presently under reorganization in three buildings named after the erstwhile noble family of the Salar Jungs. It is third largest museum in India, housing the biggest one-man collections of antiquities in the world. The museum has a magnificent global collection of art objects and antiquities, not only of Indian origin, but mostly from countries of Western. A sizable collection hails from Middle Eastern and Far Eastern origins. Apart from this, there is a children's section, a rich reference library, which contains reference books, large collection of manuscripts. This national museum, with the international standards of display of objects, is attracting huge crowds, both domestic and international tourists, whoever visit the city of Hyderabad. Thus, this museum promoting the Indian culture not only in India but also outside the country through its display of rare objects. Thus, Salar Jung Museum occupies an important place in Indian culture. It is a pride museum of India. Thank you.